Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Robert Garcia. I'm the mayor of Long Beach, and today we're at the opening of a very exciting project and really a great accomplishment on behalf of the community. We are opening, and we're at the grand opening today, of the Atlantic Farms Bridge Housing Community, or as we call it, the ABC, here in the northern part of our city. We're going to hear remarks from our council member here, Rex Richardson, Teresa Chandler, who's our deputy city manager, Kelly Colopy from the Long Beach Health Department, and Eric Lopez, who is our director of public works. As mayor, I'm incredibly proud to be here at this moment. This has been a project that we have all supported and really important for our community. As everyone knows, having a safe place to live, to eat, and to get assistance is important in our city. People experiencing homelessness need our help, and more than ever in this COVID era. There's no issue bigger in front of us than COVID-19, and that issue has made homelessness even more difficult. This new community will help bridge the gap in our continuum of care and offer a safe place for supportive services and for individuals experiencing homelessness. The ABC behind us offers 125 beds. It's for men, women, couples, and pets every single night of the year. This is a municipal-run facility with partnerships with the county and so many others within the community. And what's important about that, it's an opportunity for us as a city to really have a shelter where we can really lead and drive folks that are here and ensure that they get support. The 2.2-acre site was acquired just last year in February of 2019, and the planning and construction of this project has been exciting for the whole community. This also builds on all the work we've been doing in the city as it relates to homelessness. We've, of course, expanded shelter capacity. We've worked with organizations to ensure that giving is happening across the city. Our continuum of care and our local nonprofits are doing amazing work. And we're expanding affordable housing across the city. Over the last 5 years, which is amazing to believe, we have housed more than 5,000 individuals experiencing homelessness. That's an average of about 1,000 annually. Now, we recognize there's a lot more work to do, but the ABC here is going to be an amazing way to start a lot of that work. Now, this project was made possible through Measure H funding, which was approved by LA County voters in 2017. The city has also allocated $8 million in homeless emergency aid, HEAP funding, which we received from the state as part of a mayor's coalition, and $3 million from the Los Angeles Homeless Services Project, the grant funding for the project. I want to thank the council, all of our departments, and most importantly, to all the future residents of this place. We welcome you. Welcome to your new community, and we look forward to providing any assistance that we can. Now I'd like to turn this over to Councilmember Rex Richardson.
Thank you, Mayor Garcia. My name is Rex Richardson. I have the honor of serving the North Long Beach community right here in the 9th District. I'm honored to be here this afternoon to mark the grand opening of the Atlantic Farms Bridge Housing Community. This has been a priority for our community right here in Uptown for quite some time. And as Mayor Garcia mentioned, the City Council approved the acquisition of this site back in February of last year. This will provide a safe space for individuals who have been experiencing homelessness to rest each night and connect with resources to help them achieve permanent housing so that they can get on the right track in life. By taking the lead and addressing homelessness crisis head on, we're not only demonstrating compassion for families and for students and for veterans and for seniors, but we're also setting the stage for a transformation across our city and even right here in our North Long Beach community. This was a site, the old Atlantic Farm site, was a site that it was home to a liquor store, it was home to a family home, it formerly housed our city's winter shelter on a temporary basis. And now, it has the opportunity to not just offer temporary bridge housing, but to potentially build and create a best-in-class campus that connects comprehensive health and wellness with economic development, housing opportunities, and new amenities for our local North Long Beach neighborhood. The Homeless Outreach Network has been conducting outreach on Tuesdays and Thursdays in anticipation of the grand opening of this facility, and the network will be organized to clean up outside spaces, clearing debris and items used for outside habitation. And once the Atlantic Bridge community opens, staff will be on site regularly to engage with potential clients. We're also announcing a new initiative called the Bridge Initiative. This is a focused effort of increasing outreach and engagement in the areas within a 1 mile radius of all new shelters within the city, and that initiative starts right here in our North Long Beach community. It brings together different city departments to coordinate outreach, neighborhood cleanup, offer housing services, and case managers assigned to clients. We also are proud to say that instead of a liquor store, now we've got a nice, you'll probably see a nice sign out front that says Uptown, and we're actively seeking neighborhood serving tenants to come in and help be a part of this project. I want to thank Mayor Garcia. I want to thank the entire Long Beach City Council for their visionary work and commitment to addressing homelessness crisis right here in Long Beach, especially during this extraordinary time of COVID-19. I also want to thank the residents of North Long Beach for coming forward, demonstrating their compassion, their willingness to be a part of the solution and make a meaningful difference in the lives of so many people in our community, while also making our neighborhoods more stable and thriving. And I want to offer a thank you to our Department of Health and Human Services, our Public Works Department, Economic Development Department, and Development Services for their work daily in ensuring that this project will help us to build a stronger and more livable and more resilient city. I want to thank you to all of our partners, the service providers, the dedicated construction team and contractors. Without you, this project wouldn't be possible. And now I'd like to turn it over to our Deputy City Manager, Teresa Chandler, who's been a strong champion for addressing and ending homelessness and expanding equity across our city. Let me hand it over to Teresa.
Good afternoon. My name is Teresa Chandler, and I'm a Deputy City Manager with the City of Long Beach. I am honored and proud to be here today to commemorate the grand opening of the Atlantic Farms Bridge Housing Community. This is a first of its kind project in Long Beach that will help address the issues of homelessness in our city and propel those most in need on a path to permanent housing and long-term stability. The ABC is a testament to our dedication to ensuring equitable opportunities, including safe housing and essential services for everyone across our community. On any given day, there are at least 2,000 people experiencing homelessness right here in Long Beach. This is not an issue that can be solved alone by the city, but as a community, we can most definitely make this change happen. Through our city's model continuum of care system, sites such as the Multi-Service Center and Century Villages at Cabrillo have been able to work together to assist individuals experiencing homelessness and families to achieve self-sufficiency. This new community builds on these efforts. In addition to housing 4 dormitories with accommodations for 125 individuals each night, the campus features intake, security, and COVID-19 health screenings, of course, spacious common areas including a warming kitchen, a dining hall, a lounge, and laundry facilities. Gender-specific and gender-neutral restrooms and showers, case management and service connection offices, a family respite room for emergency overnight use, and several outdoor amenities, including a dining area, a dog run and pet relief area, a solar charging station, locations for people to store their belongings, parking lots, and more. The ABC is the first of a two-phase project on this site that will consist of a village for housing and services, including a variety of supportive housing types focused on the specific needs of individuals experiencing or at risk of experiencing homelessness. The design of this project and the modular units behind me were selected for the first phase of the community based on timeliness of installation, cost effectiveness, and flexibility in site layout. The use of these modular buildings will facilitate a smooth and cost-effective transition to a permanent bridge housing site in the future. And the city will continue to seek additional funding for the build-out of the rest of this campus. I would like to thank Mayor Garcia for his commitment to equitable opportunities for all who live, work, play, and study in Long Beach. Thank you to Councilmember Richardson for his continuous efforts to better his district and for engaging the North Long Beach community in this project through a live event back in the fall before COVID and a virtual event held most recently. I would also like to extend sincere gratitude to the hardworking staff of the Health Department, Public Works, Development Services, and Economic Development, as well as the builders and contract teams and service providers who have made the Atlantic Farms Bridge Housing Community a realization here in Long Beach. And now I'd like to introduce Director of Health and Human Services, Kelly Colopy, who has been leading many of the city's comprehensive efforts surrounding homelessness.
Good afternoon. I'm Kelly Colopy. I'm the Director of the Department of Health and Human Services for the City of Long Beach. I want to thank you all for being here to celebrate with us this incredible new campus, an incredible new set of services that we're bringing forth. The New Atlantic Farms Bridge Housing Community project reflects the city's and the health department's commitment to addressing homelessness and ensuring supportive services and resources for those in need. The Health Department leads a multi-pronged, coordinated approach to coordinate expanding capacity and enhancing service delivery to individuals experiencing homelessness and those at risk of homelessness together with many other city departments. I'm going to let that helicopter go by. Together, we come together with the Police Department and the Fire Department, Public Works, Development Services, the Library and Parks, Recreation and Marine Departments, and the City Attorney's Office. Since the start of the pandemic, Long Beach has taken a number of new measures to protect people experiencing homelessness and those who provide services to them from an ongoing spread of COVID-19. We've operated two temporary shelters. Sorry, that's windy. We've operated two temporary shelters, joined in a collaborative Project Room Key initiative, operated an isolation and quarantine site, and installed sanitation stations throughout the city. We've also distributed sanitation kits to individuals throughout the city. We've also taken important COVID safety measures as we open this shelter, including the appropriate spacing of beds, not using the top bunks of the beds in the different rooms, moving dining outside, as well as maintaining intensive sanitation protocols. We remain committed to doing everything we can to protect the health and safety of each and every one of our community members. As we know, the findings of this year's point in time count for homelessness revealed that Long Beach had a 7% increase in individuals experiencing homelessness, while we saw a decrease in those who were sheltered. This ABC shelter will have a significant impact on our ability to support those currently experiencing homelessness, but also to provide assistance to prevent them from falling into housing in the first place. This shelter, bridge housing project provides a low barrier bridge housing community designed to enable people across the city whenever they are ready for support. The campus will operate year round, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Staff and security will be on site at all times for the safety of guests and employees. Access to the site will begin at the multi-service center or through outreach services. The multi-service center acts as a central hub for serving people experiencing homelessness in the city. They see almost 13,000 people every year. The goal for each individual who stays in the bridge housing is to connect them to permanent housing. This program will work with people until they achieve that goal. The average length of stay for individuals will be about 6 months. While the site will serve adults primarily, it will also be able to help families who are in an emergency by connecting them to the family system of care. If it's after hours and that connection is not possible, there is space for them to stay here for the night so that they are safe, they're protected, and then we can help them out the following day. The ABC will help individuals access permanent housing and rapid rehousing, as well as connect them to a number of supportive services, which include health services, mental health and substance use services, employment training, benefits advocacy, and educational services. The city has selected Volunteers of America Los Angeles through a competitive process, and they will operate the site for us. Volunteers of America is a nonprofit human services organization with a long-standing history of serving people in need, strengthening families, and building communities. The ABC will be staffed with 30 full-time VOA employees. Well, it's been a very difficult few months. Today's grand opening is a great moment for our city. I'd like to thank the mayor and city council, including Councilmember Richardson, for his strong support of this project and the commitment to eliminating homelessness in Long Beach. It's also very important to thank the community members from around this neighborhood who have been so welcoming and helpful and thoughtful in their support for the building of this site. I also would like to thank LA County as they provided the funding to bring this site to life and will also provide the resources to be able to operate the site. A thank you to our City Manager Tom Modica and Deputy City Manager Teresa Chandler for their leadership. And a special thank you to our partners at Public Works, Development Services, and Economic Development for bringing what you see in front of you to be here in front of you. A big thank you to the Volunteers of America for their efforts to work with us so far. And we're really looking forward to the opportunity to be able to operate this site with them. If you or someone you know is currently experiencing homelessness, please contact the Multi-Service Center at 562-570-4500, or you can visit longbeach.gov/health. With that, I'd like to turn it over to Eric Lopez, Director of the Long Beach Public Works Department, to further discuss the build out of the project.
Thank you, Kelly. I am pleased to be here at this unveiling of this critically needed facility. Public Works started working with our city partners to design this facility in late 2019 with a clear understanding of its need in mind. Public Works broke ground on the actual physical construction of the project on March 22nd, 2020. I am proud to be here almost exactly 6 months from that date, ready for this facility to serve our residents. The tight timeline to develop this 1.24-acre portion of this lot, underutilized site, was made possible due to staff's innovative use of 12,000 square feet of pre-constructed modular buildings from our partners at William Scotsman. This project entailed a significant amount of coordination with our partners both within and outside of the city. Our success in meeting our aggressive 6-month construction schedule to complete this project is also due to their contributions and assistance. Personally, I'd like to thank Los Angeles County Sanitation District, the Long Beach Water Department, the Long Beach Energy Resources Department, our Development Services Department, our Health Department, Southern California Edison, Quality Fence, Andre Nursery, and Quality Furniture, who were all key to our success. Sustainability and convenience were at the forefront of our minds when we were developing this facility. In addition to the installation of drought-tolerant landscaping, LED lighting, we have also installed solar-powered charging stations. I want to also specifically thank a few key members from the team that made this all a reality, starting with Musen Habib. Nobody worked harder and smarter than Musen throughout the cycle of this project. Thank you, Musen. I would also like to thank Richard Dilday, Pedro Blanco, from our architects of record from Cardin Design. They are the brains behind the planning, the architecture, the design, and we are truly grateful for their assistance from day one. Also, there's two other individuals that played a key role in this project that I'd like to personally thank. He Yang from Expon and Adeline Young from Southern California Edison. They went over and beyond the call of duty to really help us out with this. Additionally, Tim Shaw, Dustin Alamo from Griffin Structures, and Troy Degener of Group Delta. Thank you all again for tuning in today.
Thank you. Muy buenas tardes y gracias por acompañarnos. Estamos aquí hoy en la gran apertura del nuevo Atlantic Farms Bridge Housing Community o Comunidad de Vivienda Atlantic Farms en el norte de Long Beach, ubicado en el 6841 North Atlantic Avenue. Hoy nos acompañó el concejal Rex Richardson, quien representa el noveno distrito, Teresa Chandler, directora municipal adjunta, Kelly Colopy, directora del Departamento de Salud y Servicios Humanos, y Eric López, director del Departamento de Obras Públicas para la ciudad de Long Beach. Todos presentes están increíblemente orgullosos de estar aquí para marcar la apertura de este proyecto tan importante para la ciudad. Como todos saben, tener acceso a un lugar seguro para vivir es esencial y crítico para todos, especialmente mientras seguimos en la pandemia de COVID-19. La falta de vivienda sigue siendo uno de los mayores desafíos de la ciudad. Antes de esta pandemia, no había un problema mayor frente a nosotros. La nueva comunidad ayudará a abordar una brecha crítica en el continuum de cuidado de la ciudad y ofrecerá un lugar seguro y recursos de apoyo para las personas sin hogar. Este centro ofrece una capacidad de 125 camas para hombres, mujeres y parejas, incluyendo las mascotas, todas las noches del año. Esto garantiza un entorno en las que las personas sin hogar pueden dormir de forma segura, pasar el día adentro y tener la oportunidad de conectarse con los proveedores de servicios y obtener recursos con el objetivo de lograr una vivienda estable a largo plazo. El sitio de más de 2 acres se adquirió el año pasado en febrero del 2019 y la planificación y construcción de este proyecto se aceleró para poder apoyar a los miembros de nuestra comunidad que se encuentran sin hogar y a aquellos que pueden quedarse sin hogar durante esta pandemia. Obras Públicas inició la construcción de este proyecto el 22 de marzo de este año. Durante la pandemia, Long Beach también ha establecido varios refugios temporales, además del existente Centro de Servicios Múltiples. Estos esfuerzos se basan en la División de Atención Continua y Servicios para Personas sin Hogar de la ciudad. Durante los últimos 5 años, Long Beach ha albergado más de 5,000 personas sin hogar, con un promedio de 1,000 por año. Este proyecto ha sido posible en parte gracias a los fondos de la medida H, que fue aprobada por los votantes del condado de Los Ángeles en el año 2017. La ciudad también ha asignado $8 millones en fondos del programa de ayuda de emergencias para personas sin hogar y más de $3 millones en fondos de subvención de la Autoridad de Servicios para Personas sin Hogar de Los Ángeles, específicamente para este proyecto. En un día cualquiera hay al menos 2,000 personas sin hogar en la ciudad de Long Beach. Este no es un problema de la ciudad que solamente ellos pueden resolver, pero si, como uno de comunidad podemos hacerlo para que el cambio suceda. A través del modelo de sistema de continuo de la ciudad, sitios como el Centro de Servicios Múltiple y Century Villages en Cabrillo han podido trabajar juntos para ayudar a las personas sin hogar y las familias a lograr autosuficiencia. Esta comunidad se basa en estos esfuerzos. Además de albergar 4 dormitorios con alojamiento para 125 personas, el campus cuenta con exámenes de salud de admisión, seguridad para COVID-19, amplias áreas comunes que incluyen cocina, comedor, salón, lavandería, baños y duchas de género y también neutros, oficinas para conexiones de servicios, una sala de descanso familiar para uso nocturno de emergencia y varias comodidades al aire libre que incluyen un comedor, un área de descanso para perros y mascotas, una estación de carga solar, lugares para que las personas almacenen todas sus pertenencias y estacionamiento y más. La ciudad continúa buscando fondos adicionales para terminar la construcción del resto de este campus. El Departamento de Salud lidera un enfoque coordinado de múltiples frentes para continuar expandiendo la capacidad y mejorando la presentación de servicios a las personas sin hogar y aquellos en riesgo de quedarse sin hogar, especialmente durante esta pandemia. Juntos con muchos otros departamentos de la ciudad, incluyen los departamentos de policía y bomberos, obras públicas, servicios de desarrollo, la biblioteca y parques, recreación y marina, y también la oficina del fiscal de la ciudad. Desde el comienzo de esta pandemia, Long Beach ha tomado una serie de nuevas medidas para proteger a las personas sin hogar y a quienes les brindan servicios a la, de la propagación continua de COVID-19. Ahorita operamos dos refugios temporales. Long Beach ha experimentado un aumento del 7% en las personas sin hogar en comparación con el año pasado, mientras que registra una disminución en la población protegida que vive aquí en la ciudad. El campus va a estar abierto todo el año, las 24 horas del día, los 7 días de la semana. El personal y la seguridad estarán presentes en todo momento para garantizar la seguridad de los huéspedes y también de los empleados. El objeto de cada individuo que se queda en esta vivienda es crear un puente para conectarlos a una vivienda permanente. El sitio prestará servicios a adultos y también podrá ayudar a las familias que necesitan apoyo de emergencia al conectarlos con el sistema de atención familiar. Pero también habrá alojamiento privado para familias que necesitan apoyo y alojamiento fuera de esas áreas de servicio que acomodan a familias. El centro ayudará a las personas a acceder a una vivienda permanente rápidamente, así como una serie de servicios de apoyo que incluyen servicios de salud, tratamiento de salud mental y abuso de sustancias, capacitación laboral, promoción de beneficios y servicios educativos. La ciudad ha elegido a Volunteers of America de Los Ángeles a través de un proceso competitivo para operar este sitio. Volunteers of America son una organización de servicios humanos sin fines de lucro con una larga trayectoria en el servicio a personas necesitadas. El fortalecimiento de las familias y la construcción de comunidades. El centro contará con un total de 30 empleados a tiempo completo. Si usted o alguien que conoce se encuentra actualmente sin hogar, comuníquese con el Centro de Servicios Múltiple donde empezará el servicio. El número de teléfono ahí es área 562-570-4500. O puede también visitar la página web longbeach.gov/ubicua/HEALTH. Gracias por acompañarnos.